Andor is a television series created by Tony Gilroy for Disney Plus. It's a prequel to the Star Wars spin-off film Rogue One. The series follows thief-turned-rebel spy Cassian Andor during the 5 years before the events of the film. And guess what? I was able to get my hands on the first 6 episodes of Andor, and now is the time to review them. Before we begin, let me remind you to please hit the subscribe button, because a lot of other early reviews are coming up, including Hocus Pocus 2, Amsterdam, Werewolf by Night, and a lot others. So now, let us begin with the review. Beginning 5 years before the events of Rogue One, the series follows an ensemble cast of characters during the time when the Rebel Alliance is forming in opposition to the Galactic Empire. One of these characters is Cassian Andor, a thief who becomes a revolutionary and eventually joins the rebellion. So, of course, it's a lot more than that, but that was the basic premise of the show. And I think the plot that they have shown here is pretty good. It has its own twists and turns and a few surprises. It's all about politics in the Empire and the condition that a lot of people are living in due to the Galactic Empire. So the rise of this rebellion is really interesting to look at and how it all comes together. But the big thing here is that plot isn't the problem, but the plot execution is. I mean, even if you have a good plot, you need to execute it very well. And even though I think the plot execution is good here, but what really is a hindrance in the plot execution is that the episodes are just not long enough. This is not going to be a rapid, rapid storytelling kind of TV show. It's not. It's a slow burn. You have to wait and you will get what you will deserve. But considering the episodes are so small, I just don't think it can hook everyone up. And that's going to be the big problem. We have to wait for one episode every week, and this is going to run for more than 2 months. So the plot execution should have been more rapid, or the episodes should have been more longer. Diego Luna stars as Cassian Andor, and we all know this character from Rogue One. He was one of the most fan favorite characters from the film. In fact, I guess the most fan favorite character from the film. And giving a backstory to that character is a really interesting thing to do for Disney Plus. He's a thief whose homeworld has been destroyed by the Empire. The series begins with Andor as a revolution-ever cynic and explores how he becomes the most passionate person who's going to give themselves to save the galaxy in Rogue One. And Diego Luna does absolute justice to the character. He's as good as he was in Rogue One, and during some scenes he's even better. So yeah, he's my favorite in the series, primarily because the whole series is about him. But other than him, I also thought Stellan Skarsgård was really good, but he was underutilized. I mean, who doesn't like watch Stellan Skarsgård on screen? That guy is a great actor, and I think he was underutilized. I would have liked more Stellan Skarsgård, but maybe I get more of him later this season. I also liked Kyle Soller as Cyril, an Imperial officer who is determined to stop Andor's rebellion. I mean, he's an extreme sense of need to impress and fill a hole in himself, and so that really is about ascending to the top of whatever field he's in. And I think even Kyle Soller does a really good part as Cyril. So yeah, these were my favorites in the cast. Comparing it to other Star Wars show, I don't think Andor is the best Star Wars show, at least not from the first 6 episodes. Maybe it wins me over in the next 6 episodes, but that's literally a lot unlikely, because The Mandalorian is my favorite, and it's by far my favorite. So it needs to be a miracle for Andor to have an amazing final 6 episodes that can elevate it to just another level, maybe above Mandalorian, but I don't know as of now, and I don't think it's going to do that. But it's surely way, way better than Obi-Wan Kenobi and Book of Boba Fett, and it's going to be really great for Star Wars fans to really enjoy some good Star Wars content since The Mandalorian season 2. So yeah, if you're a Star Wars fan, you should definitely check it out. The only problem I had here was the episodic format. I mean, this is something that should have either been binged, or at least it shouldn't have been, these small episodes. So I would like to give Andor an 8.3 out of 10. It's a great show. You should definitely check it out if you're a Star Wars fan. If you're not, I don't know. I mean, maybe you can skip it. But I'm a Star Wars fan, so I checked it out and I liked it. So that's it for today.